Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Welcome to the new tutorial. I show you today how to make this little cute kiwi fruit granny square. I'm using these four different colors of yarn: cream and green and brown and a little bit of black. For my choice of yarn, I need a 3.5 mm crochet hook, so you need also a scissors and a needle. With the first color, we start with a magic circle on the hook. And we begin with a chain 2. Counts for a first half double crochet. Now, in the magic circle, make 11 half double crochets. Yarn over, enter hook in the circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for 3. That's 1. 11 in total. 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. And 11 with your first chain 2. We have now 12 half double crochets in the magic circle. Close the magic circle to pull on that short tail, and then we can close with a slip stitch on the top of the first stitch, and that's the chain 2. In the second chain stitch, make a slip stitch like this. I make one more slip stitch to create a little knot, and then I cut the yarn. And then you can wave that longer tail here in the beginning of the magic circle, wave that in on the back of the stitches. The second color, the green, make a slip knot on the hook. And then we start with a standing double crochet for the slip stitch here. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook here in a stitch for that slip stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. This is a standing double crochet. Now back in that same stitch with another double crochet, so you have 2 double crochets in the same stitch. These 2 double crochets, that's the repeat you work all the way around. In every stitch, make 2 double crochets, yarn over, enter your hook into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, and make 1 double crochet. And a second double crochet into that same stitch. Yarn over, enter hook in the next stitch, and I place that little tail here on the back of our work, so we work over that little tail. 2 double crochets in the next stitch. 2 double crochets into the next stitch, work like this all the way around, and close with a slip stitch on the top of the first standing double crochet. I'm all the way around, 12 times 2 double crochets in the same stitch, 24 double crochets in total. Now on the top of the first standing double crochet, you make a slip stitch. Round 3, Start with the first double crochet, that's a chain 3, back into that same stitch with another double crochet. So you have here two double crochets in that same stitch. Now place that little tail here on the back of your stitches that you work around. Into the next stitch you make one double crochet. The repeat of this round. Into the next stitch, two double crochets in that same stitch, it's one and two, and then into the next stitch you make only one double crochet. That's the repeat you work all the way around. The next repeat, into the next stitch, two double crochets in that same stitch, and then into the next stitch, one double crochet. Work like this all the way around, and we close again with a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. I'm all the way around, make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet in the third chain stitch. Now make one chain, make a little knot, cut the yarn. And then we start with the next color, and that's the brown. And then with the brown color, make a slip knot on the hook. And we start with a standing single crochet anywhere in a stitch for that little tail here. Doesn't matter which one, you choose one stitch. Go in with your hook. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two. That's a standing single crochet. Back in that same stitch, another single crochet, so you have two single crochets and in the same stitch. Into the next two stitches, you make only one single crochet. That's one. Into the next stitch, also one. Into the next stitch, two single crochets in that same stitch, one. Back in the same stitch for a second, and then into the next two stitches only one single crochet. And this is the repeat you work all the way around, and you work also around this little tail here. The next repeat, into the next stitch, two single crochets in the same stitch, and then into the next two stitches only one single crochet. Two single crochets in the next stitch and into the next two stitches only one single crochet. Work like this all the way around, and then we close also here with a slip stitch into the first standing single crochet. My last repeat, in the last three stitches, two single crochets in the same stitch, one single crochet, one single crochet. Slip stitch here on the top of the first standing single crochet. Make one chain to create a little knot and cut the yarn. The cream color is back on the hook with a slip knot, and we start anywhere in a stitch here for those little knots here with a standing double crochet, yarn over, enter your hook in a stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Also into the next stitch, one double crochet. Now we make a corner, chain two. One and two. Now into the next two stitches, make only one double crochet. That's one. Into the next stitch, also one. This is your new corner. Into the next two stitches, make one half double crochet. Yarn over, enter your hook in the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through three in one go. Also into the next stitch, one half double crochet. In the next 4 stitches, make 1 single crochet. That's 1. In the next stitch, 2. In the next stitch, 3. And in the next stitch, 4. In the next 2 stitches, 1 half double crochet. That's 1. Into the next stitch, half double crochet. And work around those tails here. In the next 2 stitches, 1 double crochet. That's 1. In the next stitch, that's 2. Then we make a corner, chain 2. In the next 2 stitches, 1 double crochet. That's 1. In the next stitch, 2. For a new corner. This is the same corner than the first corner here. I show you once more the straight side. After that corner, we make 2 half double crochets. In each next stitch, 1 half double. That's 1. In the next stitch, half double crochet. Then in the next 4 stitches, single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. In the next 2 stitches, 1 half double crochet. In the next 2 stitches, double crochet. Then a quarter of a chain 2 and 2 double crochets. Work like this all the way around and then we close with a slip stitch in the beginning. I'm almost all the way around. After that 4 single crochet, we have to make for the corner 2 half double crochets. It's 1 and 2. We work all the stitches, then close with a slip stitch on the top of the first standing double crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. Round 6, and this is the final round. Start with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Now place that little tail here on the back of your stitches to work around that tail. Now we make in every stitch 1 double crochet. In the next stitch, 1 double crochet. And if you work here in the corner in the chain 2, we have to make 2 double crochets in that chain 2 corner space. Chain 2. 2 double crochets back in that same space for your first corner. Now in every straight side here, in every stitch, make 1 double crochet. Work around that tail and your first double crochet is here after that chain 2 corner space in that stitch. Now in every stitch, 1 double crochet to the next corner, and in the next corner you make 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets in that chain 2 corner space all the way around. Then we close here on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3, with a slip stitch, or you can make an invisible join. And your invisible join, you work that on the second stitch. That's the first real double crochet after that chain 3. With the black yarn and a needle, we make little stitches here on the center of the kiwi. So I place the needle from the back to the front here between the cream and the green color. And pull the yarn up and leave a little tail here on the back. Now I go with the needle under through, or through a stitch, not through and through, but I grab a little tiny stitch here on the top. You go under through, now make a little loop. You pull that thread not through and through, so I stop here. I have here now a little loop, and I go from behind through that loop. Then pull, and then you go with the needle back to that stitch where you come up from behind here in that same spot, like this, and pull your black yarn to the back. Now we have here a little tiny stitch into the next stitch, pull up from behind. Go under through a little stitch here, make a little loop. Then from behind you go with the needle through that loop. Then pull and go back in the same spot to the back of your square, like this. Show you once more. Pull up, under to a little stitch, make a loop. From behind, through that loop. And then go back to the back of your square. Make so many stitches as you want. And the kiwi fruit granny square is complete! Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!